is alternative dispute resolution, and that's any process in which the parties decide to try to resolve their case outside of a court proceeding or administrative process. And those processes include arbitration, in which the parties select a third-party neutral arbitrator or a panel of arbitrators to determine the outcome of their case, or mediation, and that's the situation in which parties select a third-party neutral to help facilitate a negotiation between them. Or parties can decide to negotiate on their own, or they can hire attorneys to advocate on their behalf and help them come up with a suitable resolution to their case. Several advantages to try to resolve a dispute outside of court, and that includes saving a lot of time, a lot of money. You can avoid the risk of an arbitrary or unfair result if you go the route of mediation, because in mediation you determine the outcome yourself. You can avoid attorney's fees and court costs. And also you have the added benefit of confidentiality, because records in a court are public, whereas in a mediation or arbitration they're not. There are three main styles of mediation: evaluative, facilitative, and transformative. In an evaluative mediation, the mediator typically has lots of expertise or experience, and the mediator uses that experience and expertise to help guide the participants to a settlement that he or she believes is reasonable based on his experience. In a facilitative mediation, the mediator asks lots of questions of the parties to help uncover their interests beneath their positions. In a transformative mediation, the focus is on empowering the participants to make better decisions for themselves and to recognize the feelings, values, and interests of the other side. And in a transformative mediation, the parties have more power over the process than they do in the other types of mediation. You select a mediator based on a few different criteria. Number one is you want to make sure they have a good reputation and are an experienced mediator. The type of mediation style that they use is also important, so you want to pick someone who uses a style that you're most comfortable with. The mediator's expertise and knowledge area is very important, because you want the mediator to understand the nuances of your particular matter. General release is used by a claimant to release the other party from all possible civil claims, both known and unknown. A mutual release just means that both parties are releasing each other. Preparation is key to a successful negotiation. You'll want to research your opposing party and their attorney. You'll want to identify your interests and prioritize them, and also consider what might be the other party's interests. You'll want to think through the strengths and weaknesses of both your case and the opposing party's case. You will need to figure out what your bottom line will be. You'll want to set a goal for the negotiation, and you'll want to think of ideas to expand the pie. Your reservation price, which is the least favorable offer you're willing to accept, based on your BATNA, or best alternative to a negotiated agreement. Your BATNA is what you expect to happen if your case goes to court and is tried. The most most effective strategy you can employ to create value is identifying interests that are of high value to you and low value to your opposing party, and interests that are of high value to your opposing party and low value to you, and trading across those differences. Trading across differences in priorities or value is called log rolling, and it increases the size of the pie. If you're good at creating value, value distribution becomes much easier.